สวัสดีครับ Good afternoon. Today is Monday, the 14th of June, 2021, and this is the English language summary of the daily press briefing here at the Center for COVID Situation Administration, or CCSA. So as mentioned in the other days and weeks past, today is the we have the opening of the schools, and of course the online learning is something very important. We have, of course, been in discussion with various organizations as well. And for example, UNICEF has learned of our opening up of schools in terms of the online classes, and they are supportive of this. I'd like to start off first with the vaccination progress that we have for today. Since the 28th of February 2021, so since for that day until today, we have a cumulative number of vaccination doses at 6.1 million doses. So we had surpassed 6 million doses over the weekend, which is very good news. So from the numbers shown on screen, it shows that more people have been vaccinated so far, and inoculation is progressing according to the plan. Earlier this morning, before we had this briefing, there was a joint press conference by the governor of Bangkok, the Department of Disease Control, as well as the CCSA, on regarding the vaccine procurement. Now, the Department of Disease Control focused on the briefing about the total number of vaccines that have been vaccinated used so far, around 6 million doses so far. Now, for the first batch of these vaccines, the correct amount had already been received in Thailand. For the second batch, there was a slight technical difficulty causing the demand to overtake the supply temporarily. Now, during this press briefing this morning by the three agencies, they reassured that this problem will be solved in due course. And the CCSA would like to apologize for the inconvenience and will continue to work hard to solve this problem. And also thank you for the public understanding. This slight postponement does not mean that the vaccination process will not go according to plan. Also that since it's progressing, despite the postponement, those who have might not be able to get their shots in the coming days, it will not be a problem, since if you have registered already, you will be getting your jabs once the batch and supply of vaccines have arrived to fill the vaccination plan that we have already. And of course, this does not affect everybody. Some of those who have appointments already and wherein the sites, the locations have the supplies already, they can continue with their jabs this week. And as I mentioned, apologies for this. It's only a temporary situation for this week, and it will be solved in due course. So this was what was briefed this morning prior to this press briefing now. Moving to the general situation, number of cases we have 3,530 new recoveries. And as for new additional confirmed case, we have 3,345. So the number of recoveries and number of new confirmed case today is slightly similar. Now for the new confirmed case, 3,000 plus, we have in that number 784 cases found in prisons, 838 from active case finding, and 10 from within the quarantine system. We have a total of 17 new fatalities recorded for today, unfortunately, making the cumulative number of fatalities now standing at 1,466. The active cases still being treated at the moment, as you see on screen in the top green box in the infographic right now, the number is steadily decreasing, which is good news. So the active cases being treated in the past days was over 40,000, almost 50,000. Now today it has for the first time decreased already, so we have around 39,000 only, and hoping that this trend will continue. Just some additional information on the numbers I mentioned just now, about the fatalities. Still, the highest number of fatalities are those from Bangkok, and one each from some other provinces in the central region. From today's number of fatality, which is 17, 7 are male, 10 female, while the median age for this group of fatality is 71. In terms of geographical distribution, the top 5 provinces with the highest number of infection remains to be Bangkok and peripheral provinces. Bangkok has the highest increase of infections today. Also, many cases can be found at the workers' camp and factories, and some in crowded communities. A new cluster has been found in Nakhon Pathom province at a pork factory. However, the Labor and Industry Ministries are speeding up their efforts to vaccinate employees, including factory workers, to prevent the slowdown of activity in the industrial sector. They plan to vaccinate more than 2.46 million employees in Bangkok within this month. Just additional info on Bangkok and other provinces. For Bangkok, a total of 84 clusters would be closely monitored in Bangkok in various areas across the capital city. As for other provinces, for Phuket now, just some progress that now approximately 60.6% had already received their first vaccine shots in Phuket. In Bangkok, we have 17.5% receiving their first vaccination. As for the reopening of venues, it was touched upon a bit just now, and you may have seen in the news that Bangkok residents have, as many Bangkok residents have begun to be vaccinated, the government has announced that some businesses in Bangkok will be allowed to resume operations starting today, the 14th of June 2021. And you have an infographic there on screen for you. The businesses with which restrictions will be lifted today include museums, parks, beauty clinics, massage parlors for foot massage only, nail salons, tattoo parlors, and etc. as you see on screen. The Bangkok Metropolitan Administration will further announce the detailed regulations for these businesses to prevent the spread of the disease, which these businesses will be asked to follow strictly to prevent the further closure of any venues. Of course, they have to be according to the standard and measures and procedures involved. So I'd like to direct your attention to another infographic from the World Health Organization. This talks about how one should go about discussing vaccines with other people. As vaccine is the talk of the town at the moment, many are interested in chatting with other people on whether or not they should get the shot. Many still have their reservations on whether they should, or they're afraid of the side effects. So please make sure that you're always emphasizing with those around you how you're feeling. Sometimes, actually, people need other people to listen. So another important issue while discussing this topic is to always share trusted information from verified sources. A slight misinformation can cause more harm than good. So with that, I'd like to complete my briefing for today. Once again, just to remind you that if you've gotten your first shot, it's still vital that you wear face masks. And you see on screen on TV, we always wear face masks, and the newscasters also as well, when they're out on air, they're always wearing face masks. The MCs, people providing the briefing this morning, for example. So remember that it's not only to protect yourself, but those around you as well. So please stay safe, stay healthy, and have a good week ahead. Have a good rest of the day, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Sawasdee krap.